As you build AI and analytic workloads, unifying your data from wherever it lives and making it accessible doesn't have to come at the cost of security. In fact, today we dive deeper into Microsoft's approach to data unification, accessibility, and security with OneLake, part of Microsoft Fabric, where we'll focus on OneLake's security control set and how it complements data discovery via the new OneLake catalog. Now, in case you're new to OneLake and Microsoft Fabric, I'll start by explaining a few core concepts. OneLake is the logical multi-cloud data lake that is foundational to Microsoft Fabric, Microsoft's fully managed data analytics and AI platform. OneLake, with its support for open data formats, provides a single and unified place across your entire company for data to be discovered, accessed, and controlled across your data estate. Data can reside anywhere, and you can connect to it using shortcuts or via mirroring. And once in OneLake, you have a single place where data can be centrally classified and labeled as the basis for policy controls. You can then configure granular, role-based permissions that can apply down to the folder level for unstructured data and by table for structured data, then all the way down to the column and row levels within each table. This way, security is enforced across all connected data, meaning that whether you're accessing the data through Spark, Power BI, T-SQL, or any other engine, it's protected and you have the controls to allow or limit access to data on your terms. In fact, let me show you a few examples for enforcing OneLake security at all of these levels. I'll start with an example showing OneLake security at the table level. I want to grant our suppliers team access to a specific table in this lakehouse. I'll create a OneLake security role to do that. So I'll just give it a name, suppliers readers, then I'll choose selected data and find the table that I want to share by expanding the table list. Pick suppliers and then confirm. Now I just need to assign the right users. I'll just add Mona in this case and create the role. Then if I move over to Mona's experience, I can run queries against the supplier data in the SQL endpoint. But if I try to query any other table, I'm blocked, as you can see here. Now let me show you another option. This time I'll lock access down to the column level. I want to grant our customer relations team access to the data they need, but I don't want to give them access to PII data. Using OneLake security controls, I can create a role that restricts access to sensitive columns. Like before, I'll name it, then I need to select my data. This time, I'll choose three different tables for customer and order data. But notice this grayed out legacy orders table here that we would like to apply column security to as well. I don't own the permissions for this table because it's a shortcut to other data. However, the owner of that data can grant permission to it using the steps I'll show next. From the role I just created, I'll expand out my tables, and for the customers table, I'll enable column security. Once I confirm, I can select the columns I want to remove and that we don't want them to see, and save it. Now let's look at the results of this from another engine, Power BI, while building a report. I'll choose a semantic model for my Power BI report. With the column level security in place, notice the sensitive columns I removed before, contact name and address, are hidden from me. And when I expand the legacy orders table, which was a shortcut, it's also not showing PII columns. Now, some scenarios require that security controls are applied where records might be interspersed within the same table, so a row-level filter is needed. For example, our US-based HR team should only see data for US-based employees. I've created another security role with the right data selected, HR US. Now, I'll move to my tables and choose from the options for this employees table. And I'll select row security. Row-level security in OneLake uses SQL statements to limit what people can see. I'll do that here with a simple select statement to limit country to USA. Now, from the HR team's perspective, they can start to query the data using another engine, Spark, to analyze employee retention, but only across US-based employees, as you can see from the country column. And as mentioned, this applies to all engines, no matter how you access it, including the Parquet files directly in OneLake. Next, let's move on to data classification options that can be used to inform policy controls. Here, the good news is the same labels you've defined in Microsoft Purview for your organization used in Microsoft 365 for emails, messaging, files, sites, and meetings can be applied to data items in OneLake. Additionally, Microsoft Purview policy controls can be used to automatically label content in OneLake. And another benefit I can show you from the lineage view is label inheritance. Notice this lakehouse is labeled non-business, as is Northwind Test. But look at the connected data items on the right of Northwind Test. They are also non-business. If I move into the test lakehouse and apply a label either automatically or manually to my data, like I'm doing here, then I move back to the lineage view, my downstream data items like this model and the SQL analytics endpoint below it have automatically inherited the upstream label. So now we've explored OneLake security controls, their implementation and enforcement. Let's look at how this works hand in hand with the OneLake catalog for data discovery and management. First, to know that you're in the right place, you can use branded domains to organize collections of data. I'll choose the sales domain. To get the data I want, I can see my items as the ones I own, endorsed items, and my favorites. I can filter by workspace. And on top, I can select the type of data item that I'm looking for. Then, if I move over to tags, I can find ones associated with cost centers, dates, or other collection types. Now let's take a look at a data item. This shows me more detail, like the owner and location. I can also see table schemas and more below. I can preview data within the tables directly from here. Then, using the Lineage tab, it shows me a list of connected and related items. Lastly, the Monitor tab lets me track data refresh history. Now let me show you how, as a data owner, you can view and manage these data items. From the settings of this lakehouse, I can change its properties and metadata, such as the endorsement or update the sensitivity label. And as the data owner, I can also share it securely, internally, or even externally with approved recipients. I'll choose a colleague, dave@contoso.com, and share it. Next, the Govern tab in the OneLake catalog gives you even more control as a data owner, as well as recommendations to make data more secure and compliant. You'll find it on the OneLake catalog main page. This gives me key insights at a glance, like the number and type of items I own. And when I click into View More, I see additional information like my data hierarchy. Below that, item inventory and data refresh status. Sensitivity label coverage gives me an idea of how compliant my data items are. And I can assess data completeness based on whether an item is properly tagged, described, and endorsed across the items I own. Back on the main view, I can see governance actions tailored specifically to my data, like increasing sensitivity label coverage and more. The OneLake catalog is integrated across Microsoft Fabric experiences to help people quickly discover the items they need, and it's also integrated with your favorite Office apps, including Microsoft Excel, where you can use the Get Data control to select and access data in OneLake. And right in context without leaving the app, you can define what you want and pull it directly into your Excel file for analysis. The OneLake catalog is the one place where you can discover the data that you want and manage the data that you own. And combined with OneLake security controls, you can do all of this without increasing your data security risks. To find out more and get started, check out our blog at aka.ms/OneLakeSecurity. Also, be sure to sign up for a 60-day free trial at fabric.microsoft.com. And keep watching Mechanics for the latest updates across Microsoft. Subscribe to our channel, and thanks for watching.